Let us hear the gospel. Peace be to all. The reading is from the Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew. Now, just as with probably a thousand
other little phrases from our church's tradition, each of which we could meditate on and use as the vehicle to our salvation, if we simply contemplate that one little sentence. This is one of those. I mean, we could do a lot with this, can't we? Most of us like to think of ourselves, or if I were to ask you, are you a forgiving person? Most people would have a reaction to say, well, yeah, for the most part. You know, just like when you come to confession and I ask, are you holding any grudges or do you hate anyone? Most of us don't wish anyone be dead. But moving back, kind of stepping away from short of death and maybe some really horrible tragedy, can we honestly say that there aren't or haven't been times that we feel as though, at the very least, when bad things happen to another person, well, maybe they're finally getting what they deserve? Don't we kind of break things in a fashion like that, where we keep score? It is just part of the way our brains work, that we keep score. And we know who the people who have kind of a high score, and we know the people who don't have much of a score at all. But when we look at this sentence, so also my heavenly Father will do to every one of you, which means to cast you into prison forever, if you do not forgive your brother, and not just forgive him, but forgive him from your heart. Now I think that, brothers and sisters, the lesson for us goes way beyond simply trying to forgive someone. Because if we are truly desiring to have as our end goal the knowledge of God, then simple forgiveness will never be enough, because we are called to forgive the way that God forgives. And the way that God forgives is with a perfect love that pours out on every single one of us in just the same fashion. It's remarkable to think that as we look at the images of the saints and the icons of our church, that God doesn't love them any more than he loves you. In fact, if we are to take to heart the little icon that's over there where confessions are heard of Jesus as the father in the parable of the prodigal son, we even get some sense that if we would say anything about God, we would say that God loves those of us who have wandered, who are rather unforgivable. He loves us with the kind of perfect forgiveness that goes way beyond how he would even love the saints who have always been faithful to him. And so our struggle is not just to take on perhaps some sort of moral or ethical sense of forgiveness, as the world would certainly agree, because it is nothing special for us to know. I mean, it doesn't take being a Christian or any other kind of spiritual or philosophical point of view. It takes none of that for us to know that it is a good thing for us to forgive each other. And we know that even just out of pure selfishness, that I will be a healthier person. I will be a happier person. I will be more at ease in the world if I just learn to forgive people. And yet, how difficult that is. So when we hear this business of, if you do not forgive your brother from your heart, it means that there's a whole other kind of work to be done here. It is not just a work of leaving someone alone. Forgiving might be somehow the equivalent of a monetary debt. Oh, don't worry about it. It's okay. You don't have to pay me back. No, it is about a change of heart. And it is about a change of heart that ultimately opens us up to the very possibility of the knowledge of God. Because as I have said recently, and as our church tells us all the time, our job is not simply to be good, our job is to be God. And when we hit that point, we notice that not only is it almost impossibly hard to forgive some people, because we have many classes of people in our lives, don't we? And we have those people who are near and dear to us. So our children, we generally speaking might say, we have no problem at all forgiving them, no matter what they do, no matter how many times, because we love them so dearly. And then there are our good friends who are almost in that category, but not quite. They, if they about. The ones we drive by on the road, the ones we encounter in the post office and at our workplaces. And then there are the people that we actually have some negative stuff going on. The stuff that they did something, said something, even decades ago, that we still kind of have stuck in our craw. And then there are those who we know are unlovable even by God. And we would somehow even pass judgment on them. You know, as members of what we call the human race, and with an understanding that we are all, every single one of us, brothers and sisters and children of the same creative God in Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. What a terrible last line of this gospel it is for us. That God virtually demands, not because he will love us any less, not because he will cast us into everlasting hell, but because if we do not love everyone, our brother, in every sense of that word, the way God loves us, then we are truly going to experience the consequence of that lack of love. So let us pray that as we hear this very simple message of a Lord forgiving a servant his debt, his monetary debt, let us be willing to contemplate that and extend that into every corner of our own lives. Let us look into those places where we think we need not look or are a little afraid to look, are just so cocksure about our righteousness in whatever the situation may be. Let us look even there and contemplate and think about what it would look like for me to truly forgive my brother from my heart. Amen.